Good morning from Expert Credit Suite. So I am still getting phone calls about how people are getting scammed and they're going to the wrong companies that are giving them unrealistic expectations, wrong time frames. They're still using the 609s. Okay, so I am telling you guys that you really need to pay attention to this. Protect yourself by asking a credit repair company these five questions. It's just five questions. Whenever you're calling, all you have to do is ask these five questions. Why? You need to worry about more than just whether you'll get the results and how much you have to pay. It's way more than that, okay? You need to worry about getting scammed and going with a company that treats you as a client instead of a paycheck, okay? So I'm just going to go very quickly through 1 to 5, okay? Very, very easy. Do you accept debit and credit, okay? Very, very simple. Don't pay with MoneyGram. Don't pay with Western Union. Don't put a bag of cash behind 7-Eleven, okay? Pay with debit and credit. And go even further than that. Look at your statement. Does it say the company's name or the company name that is, you know, on the contract or on your proposal or on the estimate, okay? If you are talking to company ABC and you're paying professional services LLC for services as described, then you know that you are going to be screwed, okay? Number two, what method do you use for the dispute process, okay? Some of these companies will not tell you. I go into great detail when people actually call me and they don't have to ask me this. I tell them, okay? I let them know that I dispute with the bureaus, the creditors, the collection agencies, that I don't use templates, that I don't use software. So you need to ask this question, okay? Are you using the 609 process, okay? Are you just sending templates? Are you actually targeting the factual information on my credit report? How are you disputing? Are you disputing online? Are you using the identity theft process? So you really need to figure this out and you need to ask that question. What method do you use for the dispute process? Number three, what is your average time frame? Now we've gone over the realistic and unrealistic timeframes and you know, all that kind of stuff. So this is definitely a question that you need to ask. What is your average time frame? So if they tell you 30 days, hang up. Okay. It doesn't work like that. And if you believe that, if you buy it, then I don't know what to tell you. Okay. I mean, you got to use common sense. There's 30 days between disputes. So how are you going to remove all your negative items in 30 days or 45 or 60, anything less than 90? Just, I mean, I'm sure you went to school, right? I mean, use your brain, okay? I'm sure you're educated. What is your average time frame, okay? If they say 12 to 36 months, hang up. If they tell you, you know what, we just kind of dispute until the negative items are off, hang up. And on top of that, I didn't even put another thing in here that you really need to ask. How many items do you dispute per month, okay? I'm even banging on my desk right now. How many items do you dispute per month? If they say 1 to 2 or 3 to 5, and that's because, you know, the bureaus are going to say that it's frivolous, hang up. That is not true. Number four, how will we communicate? If you are just going to have to call and talk to 50,000 different people and they're not going to give you answers and you can only respond by email or, correspond by email, hang up, okay? You need to be able to actually reach this person via phone and email and have whatever else they offer. You know, I even do one-on-one video consultations. I do one-on-one, sessions. So you really need to figure out how will we communicate. Make sure that you ask these questions because it's up to you to determine if their program is right for you. Number five, do you offer proof of services? No. And there was a purposeful silence right there. Do you offer proof of services? How do I know that when I pay you, you're actually going to do the job that I paid you to do? You really don't, okay? So that's one of the things that separates me from the rest, okay? And the reason that I offer it is because you are entitled to it. So when you get on the phone with them, ask, how do I know that you're doing for me what I'm paying you to do? How will I be able to track my process? How will I be able to see my disputes? How will I know that you're actually performing the credit sweep, credit restoration, credit repair that I paid you for, okay? So there's something called natural egoism, okay? So let's say that a dude goes for a haircut. You know that he's going to be, you know, at the mall, or he's going to be walking around with his girl showing off his new haircut. You know, ladies, when you get your nails done and your feet done and your hair done, you feel really, really good about yourself, and you're going to be out there showing your hair or your nails or your toes. Or if you are a barber or you're a hairstylist, you want to take a picture of that and you want to show it, and because you feel good about that. That's your profession. That's what you do for a living, and you want to show everyone how good you are. Okay, the same thing goes for companies, okay? You need to know that if someone's doing something for you, they want to actually show everybody. They want to prove, the consumer, the client, to see what is being done on your behalf, because they are proud of it, okay? So if you do not have any proof of services, what are you with them for? Why are you paying them? What are you coming out of pocket for? You're just working to pay a company to probably do nothing for you? I mean, use common sense, guys. Number one, do you accept debit and credit? Number two, what method do you use for this dispute process? Number three, what's your average time frame? Number four, how will we communicate? Number five, do you offer proof of services? Okay. If you want to protect yourself, then guess what? ECS is for you. We accept debit and credit. We do not use the identity theft process. We do not use the old school 101 process. We use the credit sweep process. That means bureau, creditor, collection agency disputes, all negative items disputed every single month. Average time frame, this program is only 6 months, not the illegal 30-day, 7-day bullcrap disputes or 12 to 36 months. It's only 6 months. How will we communicate? I already told you. Email, phone, and I even do one-on-one video. Do you offer proof of services? Absolutely. I'm the only company that does that. So if you would like to actually get your act together and obtain financial freedom, then use this link right here, free consultation, okay? expertcreditsweeps.com/book-online. So whether you go with me, whether you go with somebody, you know, across the, you know, freaking continent from you, whether you go to someone locally, you need to ask these 5 questions, okay? Protect yourself today. Protect yourself, okay? Keep yourself from getting scammed, and go with a company that actually performs a service and treats you as a client instead of a paycheck. So that was it for today, guys. Have a great day and a great weekend, even though we still have a little bit to get there. But just remember, the word is protection. So have a wonderful day, and there'll be another video coming soon.